Hello everyone, Grandmaster Paul Mull from Empowered Mastery. Thank you to this week's Inspirational Insights and Recap. I've been talking a lot about this week on constant growth and that knowledge isn't just power. And knowledge is potential power. Knowledge without action is absolutely useless. I have this belief in my head, if you're not growing and taking action, then you're absolutely dying. Sometimes I probably annoy the hell out of our team and our staff because I have very high expectations of results and taking action. And in reality, this is fear-based for me. And because I know that if you begin to get comfortable, you get complacent. You don't take action, you don't improve, you do what you always did, you're gonna get the results that you always got. And it's fear-based because, you know, one of my original mentors, you know, my dad is my original mentor as a child, but my next mentor was my original martial art instructor. And at one point in his life, you know, he was a national champion. He had two or three successful martial arts schools back in the 1980s and 90s that was really kind of like unheard of because really there wasn't a lot of professional martial artists that were successful back then. Now times have changed, you know, and he did really well. And then all of a sudden, he didn't have a master anymore. He stopped exercising. He didn't go to seminars or read books, and he wasn't a student, and he got very complacent. Fast forward, you know, that complacency around his health, you know, basically led to an early death in his mid-50s. Because if he didn't proper plan around his businesses were either closed down and there's no legacy, there's no worthy ideal that was left behind. And I knew that result was a direct reflection of lack of action and lack of growth. In his mind, he had all the knowledge, but there was no activity. There was complacency, and he got too comfortable. And I don't know about you out there listening to this video, I'm driven out of fear. I'm driven to grow. I'm driven to improve. And I don't care around any parts of your life, around your fitness, around your business, around your family, where in your life do you need to grow? Where in your life are you actually getting comfortable and complacent and really not pushing? Where are you not a student? And where do you need to become a student? Where do you need to push yourself? Where in your life do you need to grow and improve and create that mental belief that, like I have, I'm a student first, I'm continuously learning and growing, and I'm grateful with my progress towards perfection. And now I know I'm not perfect. I don't think I am. I don't believe I am. I don't think anybody is. I believe your higher power is perfection, whatever you believe in, and that you and I are a byproduct of that perfection. And so I don't care how many books you read, how many things you've accomplished. If you don't take action, you don't continuously grow and learn and improve, and you don't be a student, and you don't have the desire to just be better every day, that is a recipe for disaster. And I will guarantee you will plateau, you'll become complacent, and once you plateau, if you're not growing, you're dying, you'll be on an incline. You know, Grandmaster Kim says, very difficult to get to the top of the mountain, very easy to fall down. So that, I don't know about you, but that's why I'm constantly growing in all areas of my life. And like my partner says, I'm not slowing down. So, and if you're on my team, guess what? I ain't slowing down. But I will learn to calm down. I will learn to be a student and constantly grow, constantly improve, and be better every day and have high expectations of myself, our team, our organization, and everything I do in all areas of my life. And I hope you have the same mentality. Until next week, live life to the fullest.